Hello and welcome to round one of the 2012 FIA World Rally Championship. We're in Monte Carlo, the WRC returning to Monaco after an absence of three seasons. This year marks the 80th running of one of the world's most historic rallies. With its famous mixed conditions and difficult tyre choices, this the first time for many years that a WRC event has run over 5 days, starting in Valence and finishing in the Principality of Monaco, 18 stages in total. Well, with 17 World Rally cars and 10 Super 2000s competing, the racing will be fierce. With the Monte Carlo Rally, will it live up to its reputation as the most challenging of all winter rallies? Will grip on the roads of the Ardèche, Drôme, Haute-Loire and the Alpes-Maritimes be as unpredictable as it was in 2011 and previous years? Sebastian Loeb, 8 times a world champion, looking for title number 9 in 2012. Victory here would be the perfect start, and it'd be a brave man to bet against him. He's won here 5 times already, don't forget. He loves it.
For sure, it's good for the championship to have Monte Carlo back. It's one of the most mythic rally of the championship, and so it was not nice to see that it was not in the championship anymore. So for sure, we are happy to come back here.
The WRC's version of musical chairs has seen Mikko Hirvonen leave Ford after 6 years and 14 WRC wins and move across the service park to rival Citroën. He's there as number two to teammate Loeb, but ready to take up any chances that may come his way. Watch this space.
During all the years, you've always been thinking and kind of laughing with Jarmo. It would be really nice to get in that team sometime and drive the car and see what they're really doing differently. Now we got the opportunity, so I didn't even want to throw it away. Like I said, I'm really happy that I made the decision and came here.
Well, with Hirvonen leaving Ford, that elevated Jari-Matti Latvala to number one status. Yeah, strong performances last year, particularly on tarmac, and now in his 5th year with Ford, he's the one charged with beating Loeb.
To beat Loeb and Citroën, you need almost like a perfect year, but that's why we are here. We want to challenge it.
And what about Petter Solberg? Well, after 3 years of running his own team, Solberg is back in a factory car and returns to the team where he had his first works drive in the WRC back in 1999. He drives the second Fiesta in the Ford team.
Really good, and of course this is something we have been working on for the last 3 years now, and everything is possible.
How close were we to losing Petter Solberg in the World Rally Championship?
It was very close, because it was this or nothing. And then I would have gone Le Mans World Touring Car, that's it.
Minia back in 2012, after their part season last year, where they made 2 podiums. Full campaign is planned this year, with Danny Sordo remaining as the number one driver. But things haven't been easy. A lack of a sponsor has forced the team to look for a paying driver for the second car, leaving Chris Meek on the sidelines at home and filling the second seat this weekend with the Corsican Pierre Campagne. Well, a new face in the WRC for this year is the Belgian Thierry Neuville. He brought in by Citroën to try and build up the team for the future, the AL years, the after Loeb years. The 2011 Belgian Driver of the Year will be wanting to do better this time than he did last year on the IRC. So, Moulins to Entraige, 36.87 kilometres in total, the longest stage of the rally. Well, important tyre choices at the start of day one. Some snow reported in the first part of stage two, but on one, dry with some damp patches. Teams having to decide at the very last moment. Citroën going for soft Michelins, 2 tyres with studs in the boot. Ford takes the extra soft Michelin, and also 2 tyres with studs in the boot. Drivers have 5 choices, extra soft, soft, hard, and snow tyres, either with or without studs. So, choices made, and you have to stick with them. Sebastian Loeb, 5 times a Monte Carlo winner. Loeb, first on the road. Always at home here, setting a time of 24.04. No problems, a good stage. with those soft Michelin slicks. Well, first stage as a Citroën driver for Mikko Ervinen. Won the Monte Carlo in 2010 at the wheel of a Ford Fiesta S2000 in the IRC and was second behind Loeb in the WRC in 2008. Good rhythm for him, taking no risks, getting used to the car, of course, but loses 14.9 to Loeb here. Jari Matti Latvala. Super soft tyres, remember, for him. Fourth best time, shedding 22.2 to Loeb. Super soft, clearly not the best choice for stage one, but could be better suited for the snow and ice, reported on stage two. Latvala always had a good pace and has now become a threat to Loeb on tarmac as well. Danny Sordo, soft tyres for him, same choice as Loeb and Ervinen. Great second fastest time, only 1 second behind Loeb. His ice crew had warned him about ice on the road, so Sordo was actually cautious here, maybe a little bit too much so, because in the end the ice had melted away. Took two podiums for Mini in 2011, second in France and third in Germany, don't forget. Simulcam time. Yes, our special toy that featured throughout the rally. With Simulcam, we're able to compare two drivers on the same stage, on the same sector, and our first Simulcam overlay situated 22 kilometres into stage one. About 1 kilometre after the Col de Foyol, we put Sordo against Latvala for this one. Sordo on the soft compound, same as Loeb. Sordo a bit faster than Latvala at this same stage. The Mini has more grip during acceleration out of corners. Based on this footage, Sordo should have done the faster time, but he lost some precious seconds in the last 10Ks. Caution cost him dear. And for stage two, sun and, snow coming up as well. Stage two, a difficult one. Bouzet to Martial, 30.48 kilometres. With the snow in the first part, ice on the descent towards the finish. Well, the temperature had dropped. Minus 10 now as Sebastian Loeb got underway. Done an extraordinary tyre setup. Studs on the front left and right rear. Soft slicks on the front right and left rear. A diagonal setup. Must be a strange feeling to drive, even for the world champion. But the soft compound was still too hard for the icy conditions towards the end of the stage. 22, 20, dead for Loeb.
We have a mixed tyre choice with a stud on the front left and on the right rear. So it's a bit, it's very strange to drive, but it was okay. We had a good compound choice for the first stage. In this one, the two slicks were too hard, so we are losing for sure some time. But I didn't want to take big risk. It's only the start of the rally. It's very tricky.
Lavalle lost 22 seconds to Loeb on the first stage. Also decided to cross-match his tyres, did the same as Loeb. Still on the front left, still on the right rear. But Lavalle is on super soft slicks, and that's better suited to these conditions. He flies along 57.7 faster than Loeb. Lavalle taking the rally lead and pushing Loeb into second by 30.5 seconds. A good tyre choice by Ford. As for Danny Sordo, missed out on winning stage one by only a second, but like Loeb, in trouble on the soft tyres on his Mini. Yes, it gets really bad for Sordo as well. Loses grip. Double kiss. Mini out of shape, but Sordo managed to get the car to the finish. He lost a minute and five, drops to fourth after stage two. Mini crew in the service park preparing to do some work. The conditions, though, changeable. And with differing choices, the field being levelled out, you might say. But Sordo down to six. Bumped, bruised, but unbowed. Well, a brilliant performance from Ford and Jari Matti Latvala.
I have seen Citroën using it in the past, and also Petter did a good job. He told me that would be a clever thing to do, but I never tested, so I trusted Petter, and it was a good thing to do.
Getting ready then for the second loop of two stages we had in the morning. Time to do it all again. Second run then of Moulin to Entrege, just after 20 past 2 in the afternoon local time. Well, Sebastian Loeb was to be quickest again on the second run here. Loeb said it was a good stage. Nothing bad happened. Well, another mixed tyre choice. Super soft in the front, soft at the rear. Lavala, second fastest on the stage, but only 0.4 behind Loeb. Very good stage, gaining more and more confidence on tarmac, a surface he previously said he didn't much care for. Well, with Loeb only gaining 0.4 of a second, Lavala still having a healthy lead of 30.1. So, let's compare Loeb and Lavala with the simulcam, shall we? A different tyre choice for Loeb and Lavala, but they run equally fast at this point on stage three, some 20 kilometres into the stage, right after the Col de Foyol. At the finish, Loeb was narrowly faster. After the long stage, the drivers have a little break, passing through the village of Entrege and collecting the famous tarte aux pommes, an apple pie made by the Joigny family. They've been doing it for years. Yes, and apparently every driver seems to love it. And some of the bigger names of the past as well. Second run of the Berzée stage had snow and ice on top in the earlier loop, don't forget. So 20-4 in the afternoon, Lavala going on to stage four with a lead of half a minute. He chose the tyres that Loeb went for on the first loop, soft slicks combined with studded tyres, but a momentary lapse of concentration, the Finn looking for ice and missing his notes, he said. Oh dear, out of the rally, no super rally, called Rally 2 in the Monte.
And there was quite a fast right-hand corner with Titans at like 90 right, and ice started on that corner. And I started to only look and concentrate for the ice. And I didn't concentrate to my notes. I only looked the ice, and then when the corner tightened, I had too much speed. I thought that, okay, I tried to get it back, but it went wide. There was a little bank, and after the bank, there was a straight three-meter drop. The rear tires went to the drop, and after that, the whole car went there and landed on the side. No big damage, but no chance to get out.
Yes, mea culpa from Latvala. Another fastest time for Loeb, his third of the day was in the offing. And with Lapvala retiring, Loeb in the lead, and a comfortable one at that. 1 minute and 4.2, the margin on the field. Well, we were already talking about a possible sixth victory on the Monte for Loeb, and why not? Ogier setting the sixth best time on the last stage, another brilliant performance for him. Fourth overall in front of Ford Fiesta's WRC driver, Yevgeny Novikov. In tricky conditions, Ogier, don't forget, at the wheel of his S2000 without a turbo, matching the performance of the WRC Armada. The legend that is Delacour, finishing the day with the second fastest time, 35.4 behind Loeb. Delacour said sometimes that this day was so fast he had some trouble following the pace notes. But the Monte Carlo winner is still fired up, just as much so as he was 20 years ago. Well, a bad moment along the way for a couple. Thierry Neubild, well, sadly for him, ends up in a wall. No punctures, but the crash ripped up the right front wheel of his Citroen. Had to park his car at the side of the road, rally over. Before his accident, Neuville was eighth in the overall classification. A real shame. Yes, organisers had the choice of whether to go with Super Rally, it's called Rally 2 now, and allow drivers to continue, but they decided not to take up that option. So some big names had been lost to us. So the overall classification after day one, Loeb and Elena leading Sordo and Del Barrio by a minute and four. But look at that situation between second and third. Yes, a real scrap for podium place.